Hi friends, welcome back to VLSI Fab. As I promised, I will be taking all your doubts. So here I have come with a video, Physical Design Flow, in the 5-minute series. As most of the people are having confusions in the complete PD flow, so without wasting time, let's start the video. I request everyone to watch till the end. So physical design is a process of transforming a circuit description to a physical layout. So where we will start with a RTL, described in Verilog or VHDL, and we will take it to the layout through different steps. Mainly there are two main steps we need to cross: synthesis and PNR. So to get the layout, and once the layout is complete, we do the following signoff checks to ensure the functionality of your design. So if you want to know in details of synthesis, please watch ASIC synthesis in DC video of VLSI Fab. So for synthesis, we will be taking RTL constraints such as power, area, timing constraints, and target library such as 45 nm, 22 nm, etc. And we will do the necessary synthesis. So, and the output of synthesis is also a gate level netlist, which is again in standard Verilog format. So netlist can be simulated as well, which we call as gate level simulation. So please watch gate level simulation video in VCS in my channel VLSI Fab. So from the example, you can see Y equals to A or B and C or D. So this is the RTL. And finally, after synthesis, we got the netlist in terms of standard cells, which is also described in Verilog. Once the synthesis is complete, we get the gate level netlist, and we need to import it along with other files such as SDC, UPF and other required library files to the PNR tool such as ICC2 or Innovus to complete the layout. Floor planning is the first major step in getting your layout done. So your floor plan determines your chip quality. So floor plan includes: define the size of your chip or block and aspect ratio, then defining the core area and IO core spacing, then defining ports specified by the top level designer engineers, and IO placement, pin placement, then allocates power routing resources. Then again, you can see the macros M1, M2 that place the hard macros and reserve space for standard cells. So please refer rules for placing hard macros in one of my videos I have given, that is in my channel itself, and defining placement and routing blockages. So like creating input output rings, creating the pad ring for the chip. So all these things will be done in a floor plan stage itself. So next stage is placement, where we place our standard cells in the design. So placement determines the routing ability of a design. So a well constructed placement solution will have less routing demand and will distribute the routing demand more evenly to avoid routing hotspots. And also power consumption is also affected by placement. A good placement solution can be reduce the capacitive load because of the wires, and hence the switching power consumption can be reduced. CTS. So CTS is the process of insertion of buffers or inverters along the clock paths of ASIC design in order to achieve zero skew or balance skew. The goal of CTS is to minimize the skew and insertion delay. So apart from this, useful skew is also added in the design by means of buffers or inverters. As clock is the only signal that switches frequently, which in acts as a source for dynamic power dissipation, so we treat clock as clock separately, and we do the CTS. Routing is the process of creating physical connections based on logical connectivity. So signal pins are connected by routing metal interconnects. So routed metal parts must meet timing, clock skew, max trend cap requirements, and also physical DRC requirements. So once the routing is completed, we do the metal filling, and finally we do the necessary checks, like signoff checks on the design, and we check whether the quality and performance of the layout is fine or not. Once it's fine, then we extract the GDS and we send it to the foundry. So thank you guys for watching the video. Please like, share and subscribe.